Although when you look up at the sky, it may seem as though the stars are fairly well spread, star formation actually isn't regular throughout the universe. Mostly due to gravity, matter clumps up, and stars tend to form more in certain areas where lots of ingredients are available, while other areas see no new stars being born at all. And, as it turns out, no new stars have been formed around our own solar system in quite some time, apparently placing us in the center of one of these barren regions. This is Unveiled, and today we're answering the extraordinary question, did scientists just discover that we live in a cosmic bubble?
Do you need the big questions answered? Are you constantly curious? Then why not subscribe to Unveiled for more clips like this one, and ring the bell for more thought-provoking content.
It was a few decades ago when scientists first noticed something very strange about our placement in the universe. In the 1970s, astronomers realized that new stars don't form anywhere near our solar system, and that all the closest stars to us are either very old and have been there from the start, or are younger, but have drifted closer over millions of years, meaning they never formed especially nearby. This led researchers to theorize that there was a sort of bubble they called the local bubble surrounding our system, determining that no new stars have formed inside of this bubble for at least 14 million years. Interestingly, our solar system is almost directly in the middle of this seeming void, with barely any new stars forming at all around us for around 500 light years in all directions. Even within the vast expanse of the universe, we can class ourselves as decidedly cut adrift then. But new research may finally shed light on how our local bubble operates. The multi-authored study, published in January 2022 in the journal Nature, leads with the headline, "Star Formation Near the Sun is Driven by Expansion of the Local Bubble." Using data from the European Space Agency's Gaia Space Observatory and creating a three-dimensional map through software called Glue, created by one of the lead authors, Alyssa Goodman, researchers were able to create a visualization of our bubble, including its timescale and its relationships to other nearby formations. So, what did they find? First, although it's called the local bubble, it's not perfectly round by any means, and is shaped more like a blob. It's around 1,000 light years long, and we're positioned roughly in the middle, although that's only by chance. It suggested that our solar system just so happened to drift into the bubble around 5 million years ago, and it's expected to leave it in another 8 million years or so. The bubble's insides or contents are otherwise mainly empty, but scientists still describe the space as a cavity of low-density, high-temperature plasma surrounded by a shell of cold, neutral gas and dust. As dramatic as that sounds, it means mostly empty space on the inside, lacking in the ingredients necessary to birth stars. Chiefly, this analysis enables researchers to understand why it is that we don't have any newborn stars as neighbors. Broadly speaking, stars form due to gravity pulling in large amounts of gas and dust until the mass gets so large that the entire structure collapses in on itself and ignites. In order for that to happen, however, you first need large amounts of gas and dust, but that's not what we have inside of the cosmic bubble. There's some cosmic material, yes, but not nearly enough for star formation. The leading theory as to why this is the case suggests that around 14 million years ago, a series of supernovas, perhaps 15 in total, took place that reshaped the local spread of star fuel. It's thought that these supernovas created blast waves that pushed all the gas and dust that had been here outwards until it settled on what's now the edge of the bubble, at which point all of that accumulated star stuff began birthing new stars over and over again, which has evidently resulted in no stars for light years around, and then a flurry of star activity at a certain distance away from us. According to the 2022 study, there are then multiple regions relatively close by that do tend to birth new stars more so than other areas, and they all sit somewhere near the surface of the bubble, but not inside it. These star clusters include Corona Australis, Perseus, Cepheus, and other major constellations. Looking ahead to the future, while researchers believe that our bubble is still forming and it will continue to grow for the time being, it's thought it won't grow forever. The bubble is currently expanding at a rate of about 4 miles per second, but that rate is not expected to increase. In fact, it has been steadily decreasing since the last of the supernovas millions of years ago. Eventually, the bubble will stop growing and start to lose its shape. No one can be precisely sure when it will disappear entirely, but it's thought likely that by the time our own sun drifts out of this area in 8 million years from now, there won't then be a bubble left to exist. Rather, there may well be space for opportunity for stars to more easily form again in this region as the universe continually evolves. Importantly, it's not as though our local bubble is held to be an anomaly in any way. There are likely many more cosmic bubbles littered throughout the universe, formed and operating in a similar manner. There are likely many more seeming voids, relatively lacking in the conditions for star formation, but with an outer edge along which stars form freely. And actually, we're already aware of a few that exist close to and even intersect our own. One of these bubbles is called the Loop 1 bubble. It exists around 330 light years from the Sun and was also formed out of supernovas, pushed into being by the resulting stellar winds. This bubble has tunnels that connect it to our own as well, to the point where we might imagine the two to be connected, much like seas and oceans are on Earth. Other bubbles close to us are the Loop 2 and Loop 3 bubbles. And although researchers still aren't sure on the details of how this network of cosmic bubbles might affect one another, those behind the 2022 study have compared the setup to plowing snow. What's meant by this is that there are some regions along the edges of these bubbles where the stardust or snow that's pushed out overlaps. And this is why we have some regions with far higher stellar birth rates than others. We can see, then, that by analyzing these parts of space where seemingly not much happens, we can begin to map and predict what's unfolding all around us with greater accuracy. This research is an important step forward toward understanding the complex layout of the Milky Way galaxy, and also of the universe as a whole. It may be some 50 years since the idea of cosmic bubbles was first floated within academic circles, but we're now finally beginning to fashion visualizations of the structures themselves. We're now finally realizing the reality of our own bubble, including how it formed, and for how much longer we'll be floating through it. But more than that, we also now know why it is that we seem to be in a region that's so barren of new star formation. Importantly, there are still millions of stars, in general, to be found within our own bubble. It's just that they're likely either older than 14 million years, when the first supernovas unfolded, or they didn't form here and have just drifted this way. After all, that's what happened with our own sun. It passed through on its own magnificent voyage millions of years ago, and it won't pass out the other side for millions of years more. It's another incredible process to show just how staggering the universe really is, in beauty, mystery, and intrigue. Even when, seemingly, nothing's happening, no stars are forming, and we're surrounded by literally hundreds of light years of barren space, there are still some amazing things taking place. Cosmic explosions from millions of years ago are still shaping our surroundings, and the stars that twinkle in the sky are still only just revealing their true stories. It's a long voyage of exploration and knowledge, and that's how scientists discovered that we live in a cosmic bubble.
What do you think? Is there anything we missed? Let us know in the comments. Check out these other clips from Unveiled, and make sure you subscribe and ring the bell for our latest content.